Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hi, my name is Dr. Daboski. Today, let me have you with a video today on Chapter 3. The first part of Chapter 3 deals with the differences between cash versus accrual basis accounting. So, that will cover learning objectives 1 and 2. So cash basis versus accrual basis accounting is first that we talk about what cash basis means. Basically, when we talk about cash basis accounting, what we're saying is that we record our revenues only when the cash is received. And we record expenses only when cash is paid. However, the main rules that we must follow for accrual accounting, if you remember the metaphor from the language metaphor that I gave you early on when we talked about the fact that the accounting language has creative writing. And the creative writing is expressed through what we know as accrual basis accounting. This is where we record revenues only when they are earned, and we record expenses in the period in which the benefit is received, or what the associated benefit is received. If you remember the acronym I gave you for remembering accrual accounting, it was Lake Erie, E-R-I-E, where E stands for earned, R stands for revenue, meaning revenue needs to be earned. Then I stands for incurred, and E stands for expense, and expenses must be incurred. So this is going to be the focus of this short little video on differentiating accrual versus cash basis accounting. Accrual basis is what we use most of the time. As you're aware, revenue recognition is very important. So let's take a transaction that on December the 15th, the customer orders services. On December the 28th, the company performs services on account, however the customer does not pay. January 12th, the company receives cash from the customer. On which day should the company record the revenue in this transaction? Think about it for a second. Go back to the sight word list that I gave you earlier on in an earlier video. Remember the word order, or the sight word order, generally does not conjure up or result in an accounting entry. However, the sight word performs services is a sight word that means what? Correct. Revenue has been earned. And then it does not matter when the company receives the cash, because in accounting under accrual basis, we record revenue when it's earned. Remember Erie, Lake Erie. So under cash basis, however, we record cash when the cash is actually received, which doesn't incur until when? Correct. January 12th. So on cash basis, we will learn or earn the revenue on January the 12th, the date of the cash inflow, but for accrual basis, we will recognize it on the earned date. Consider this. December 15th, the company orders services. December 28th, the company receives cash from the customer in advance. Again, another sight word where you're receiving in advance. Go back to the sight word list that I posted on my last video on sight word help. You remember when we receive money in advance, we have not performed yet, but we have an obligation to perform, which means we must set up a liability. And then on January 12th, the company performs the service. So on which day should the revenue be recorded here? On cash basis, it's when they receive the cash, which is December 28th. For accrual basis, you need to look for the sight word performs, performed, rendered services, something that tells you that the services were completed. And that does not occur until January 12th, and that's when we would earn it here. For expense recognition, consider this fact. December 15th, the company orders office supplies. December 28th, the company receives and uses, another sight word, uses, office supplies, and then on January 12th, the company pays for the supplies purchased. The word pays means cash is going down, decreasing, if you go back to the sight word list. So here we're dealing with what are the accrual based and cash basis expenses. For cash basis, when would we record the expense for supplies? Right, when it is paid. It's paid on January 12th, the date of the cash outflow. When is the expense incurred? Remember, go back to Erie, expenses are incurred. It's incurred when they are used up. Correct. The sight word used. So they use them all on December 28th. So that would be the date the benefits received or the associated cost are received. So we will expense it on that date. Consider this fact. December 15th, the company orders the supplies. December 28th, the company receives the office supplies and pays cash. And on January 12th, the company uses the office supplies. So again, we have to differentiate between cash basis. When do we actually pay for them? That's when the expense would be recognized under cash basis. And then for accrual basis, we only recognize expenses when they are incurred. And they're incurred when they are used up or consumed, or some past tense verb, used, consumed, expired. So on which day would the company record the expenses under cash basis? Think. January 12th. That is correct. Right? I'm sorry, December 28th. That's when they paid for them. Sorry. And then the accrual basis. It's when they are used. So of course, that has to be January 12th. That's the date the benefit is received. Revenue and expense recognition. So revenue recognition, we record all revenues when they are earned. For expense recognition, any costs used to generate the revenues are recorded as expenses in the period the revenue is recognized. So remember, we call this the matching principle. And under the matching principle, the expenses follow the revenues. We first do a shout out and we say, "Where are my revenues?" Right? And then once we have revenues earned, we then immediately have to do a shout out for our expenses. Where are the associated costs of producing those revenues? And they must be recorded in the same period. So if we look at a three-period example, period 1, period 2, and period 3, we have a cash outflow in period 1. We have another cash outflow in period 2, the period in which we provide the service, and in period 3 we have another cash outflow, and that's also we have the cash inflow from providing the service. So when is the revenue recorded, in period 2 or period 3? Look at the sight word, look for the right word, providing, provided, correct, that would be period 2. That's when the revenue would be recognized. When should the cost be expensed? Shown in the income statement is what we mean, in period 1, 2, or 3. Right? Well, where was the revenue earned? Well, it was earned in period 2. So we need to have an expense recorded in period 2 as well, because that's an associated cost of producing the revenues. So we know that accrual basis is the preferred method of accounting because it gives us a truer recognition of assets, which are known as future resources, and our liabilities, which are our future obligations. And it provides a better matching of revenues, which are the benefits, and expenses, which are the associated costs of the benefits. And it provides a better indication of future cash flows. We know that generally all companies must follow accrual basis accounting, except small ones that are not publicly traded. Well, this concludes our video today. I hope this helped you to differentiate between cash basis accounting and accrual basis accounting under generally